I found my thrill on Blueberry Hill. On Blueberry Hill, when I found you in all the moon stood still. And it lingered until my dreams came true.
Dan Murphy, caught you.
How are you?
Haven't seen you for ages. How are you?
Not so bad, thank you.
This How is all you? Put on. I did see him. You've just been to the toilet, haven't
That's
you?
Correct, yeah.
That's right. I did see Stan before he went in, but you've got to make it look as though it's spontaneous and real. No, a genuine question, though, Stan. I haven't seen you before today for ages. How are you?
Not so bad, no. Back in training.
Yeah, I noticed you running the other day.
A couple of miles.
Do you think this is wise?
Well, we'll find out. Only time will tell. No, I'm not doing much, just enough to keep the fat off.
Where are you now? You're still in the same place, aren't you, the
manor hospital, yes.
Are you going to be entering any more marathons?
No.
That's definitely out.
It's definitely out, yeah. I might do small races, you know, but no, I don't think so. To be safe, never.
Well, it's good to see you back here. I'm holding Stan up from a meeting now, I believe, so I'll let you go.
Right,
good to see you again, Stan.
Cheers.
Chris and Stan.
No,
and
no, no.
Do the way round.
I'm Stan. No, no, she's Chris. No.
Oh, you're Chris. And you're Stan.
No. No, I don't know. This is Stan.
As you've guessed, either a double act or you've got something to show us. Are these for sale?
She or me? Oh, you mean the puppets? No, this is for sale. I'm a raffle.
Mm-hmm.
And Chris is one in a million.
7 to 7.
Where's your smokes go?
No, oh, nice thing. See if you got some smoke if you want.
You're right, Ron.
This
expression of ideas as part of the multidisciplinary team, and equally as individuals.
Human understanding, cheerfulness, intelligence, and some other social skills like dancing, music, the ability to talk to people, to sit down and chat with an old person. But I think more important than that is the ability to sit and listen to what they've got to say.
Right, now this week's programme comes to you from the Heavy Workshop sale. I have two delightful women with me. One is Bette and one is Mary. Is that right?
No.
Okay, correct me.
Well, I'm Eve and I work here.
And I'm Esme and I'm a voluntary worker.
Right, and I can see that you're selling cakes and you've almost sold out. Well, almost.
You've done very well.
Very well indeed.
Tell us exactly what you do.
I'm an occupational therapy helper, and I cook with the patients.
Right, but Ismay, is it?
Esme.
Esme,
yes.
You're a volunteer.
I'm a volunteer.
So how long have you been volunteering here at the hospital?
From January, and I leave today.
Do you?
Yes, I'm going into a full-time job.
Well, on my way to the next stall, I thought I'd just stop off, sit on a bench and talk to two members of the domestic staff who don't very often appear on our programme, and they should appear more often, I think. So let's introduce you to...
Mrs. Paul, Mr.
Oh, how formal. What's the first
Barbara.
Name? Barbara. Can we call you Barbara?
You can call me Barbara. Andrini.
Andrini, okay. Yes. You always seem to support these sales. Every time we go to one, you're here, or members
all
of your department.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
What was that, Trevor? Trevor's terrific toasties.
No, if it were for the domestic staff, you'd get no sales. I'm telling the truth there.
Well, I'm sure Trevor appreciates it.
You might know it's summer. I reckon it's the heat that brings them out, especially when it's the day of the Daresbury-sponsored bike race. And this year is no exception. The ride starts outside Daresbury Ward and wings its way through the Cheshire countryside with various stops at specified locations, namely most of the hostelries in the area. But that's only to collect some well-deserved cash from the patrons. Excuse me while I just have another. Some of the main characters of the event were Sabrina Douglas, that extrovert younger sister of Stan from Leighton OT. Hasn't she got just gorgeous hair? But the prize for the best body and the most beautiful rider of the day went to that Spanish siren, Lulu Coella. And Lulu is the disowned cousin of Louis from the gym. Louis, how could you disown such a beauty?
From Airby Ward, and I'm here this afternoon because Mrs. Fowley has kindly consented to draw the tickets for our raffle this year.
Right.
Mrs. Fowley.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
Right, I'll stir them all up a bit. First prize, which is for a hamper.
Yes.
Right. That's 308. That's Carol from Patients Outfitters.
Lovely. Right? Yes.
Two. And that's for a cuddly toy. That's 367. That's Carol from Oscroft Ward.
Thank you.
And the final one is 348, and that's Elaine Lloyd from Whitby Ward.
Elaine.
And she wins a box of chocolates. We'll be round to collect the chocolates after Elaine.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory stray to a bright summer's day when you kiss me and call me?
Don't let there be men there, ain't a drop of golden sun. Me the name I call myself, but a long way to roam.
Guess who? With or without glasses, it's Barbara Tunnicliffe.
I've taken them off, yes.
Sorry?
I've taken my glasses off.
I'm glad you reminded me. Right, tell us what it's all about.
Well, we're having a sale here today to raise funds for a party for carers and clients at Christmas, and it's on the 12th of December. We have it in the evening in this room from 7 till 10. And it helps us to provide entertainment for them, although the staff are doing quite a lot of entertainment this year.
I believe so. I've just been talking to Sylvie, and she tells me that you're playing the part of Widow Twankey. Is that right?
No, actually, I'm the fairy godmother.
Cats in the hospital grounds are the feral cats.
Can you explain some feral cats?
Well, feral cats are cats probably that have started off by being dumped in the hospital ground and have bred and interbred, and there's quite a large population of these feral cats. Now, they're a different kettle of fish to the actual domestic cats that quite a lot of wards have.
On behalf of all the causes, right?
Happy birthday to you.
Okay, yeah. Dad. God bless. Happy birthday. Merry Sheen Mother.
Yeah. Shake hands with the lads.
Yeah. Happy birthday, no. Happy birthday, no.
Happy birthday,
Happy birthday, no. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Oh, God bless you.
You got a knife? Can you have a
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Molly. Happy birthday to you.
It happened on the way a long time. Oh, and met her in Monterey, where I started to go. Stars and silky dogs and rotted lips, a red wine. Rose, some of the dog, and I'm afraid that this was mine. I left her in Monterey without thinking twice. I left her and threw away the keys to paradise. My mistress, sweetheart, longs for a sweetheart that I left no Monterey.
Thank you very much.
John from Barton, who's going to draw the numbers for this month's 400 Club draw. This is the end of October draw. Let's do it with the highest prize first, John. Can you pick out a number for £100?
Yes, one.
Every number in this bag represents a member of the 400 Club.
Yeah.
Now, there should be a number on that.
Yes, four.
Just slipped away from the Kelso Day Hospital sale, and I'm standing at the foot of the stairs leading up to Tarvin Ward. Now, on Tarvin, the charge nurse is Brian Eccles, and we're going to surprise him, and I hope he's pleased with his surprise. I won't tell you what it is. I don't even know if he's going to be there today. I'm told he's on duty, but it's all spontaneous. Follow me up the stairs and let's see if we can surprise Brian. Be as quiet as I can be. I don't know why I'm being quiet, really. It all adds to the hush-hush secrecy of it all. Nobody else knows on the ward. I haven't told anybody else either. We're just going to walk in and hopefully surprise everybody. I don't know where he is. Let's try his office.
Hiya.
Hello, Brian.
Yeah.
Brian Eccles. Good to see you. We've got a little bit of a surprise for you, Brian. I haven't told you about it. I don't know if you've watched Viper television recently, but we did a Viper 400 Club draw last week. Mm-hmm. I'm pleased to tell you, you have won £100.
Oh, that's smashing old.
First prize.
That's great.
Brian Eccles is a lifetime supporter of the Viper 400. Actually, you were an original member, weren't you?
I was. I've won once before, actually.
How much?
It was a very small prize. I think it was the first draw, won about five or something like that.
Well, I'll tell you what, you deserve it, because you're number four in the draw, which means you've been a member, I think, since 1979.
That's right.
Yeah?
That's right, Alan, yeah.
It's been a long time coming, but congratulations.
That's very, very nice. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Just the way I am.
have explained to you this is a case worthy of Sherlock Holmes himself. But to fill you in on the details of it, we'll speak to Bill Sheridan, who's a charge nurse on Airby Ward.
3 weeks ago, I obtained a budgie on an exchange basis from Mr. Edwards, that's charge nurse Dave, over on Carden Ward. Budgie I had at home was a bit naughty, and he gave me a baby, about 5 weeks old. Saturday afternoon, I was listening to the match on the radio, and I was interrupted by the children, who said, "Dad, the budgies flew away." He flew in the direction of Saltney.
Excuse me for interrupting you there, Bill. Yeah. Was there any kidnap note left?
No kidnap note, no.
Not well, we've... So there was...
There's nothing in the letterbox.
Nothing there?
Nothing, no.
Right. OK, carry on.
I'd already warned the children that he was a good flyer and that if they ever let him out, we'd never catch him. Yeah. Well, he went like the spaceship that the Americans send up, you know. Zoom, straight over the poplar trees. He didn't even wave goodbye, you know.
Oh, dear. That's it. Had you been cruel to him or anything?
No. He might not have been a Liverpool supporter, because that was a match on the radio, you know, but...
Ah, it's certainly a bit of a mystery. Was his pocket money stopped or anything like that, no?
Nothing. Plenty of food, plenty of water.
Well, I think the only thing that we can do for you, Bill, is to bring in a real super sleuth. Yeah. And see if we can find him. Can you give us a description of him?
Pale green. Lost his tail.
With no tail, yeah.
He's got this beautiful white bracelet. Don't know whether it's diamonds or...
Did he leave any fingerprints anywhere?
No, droppings.
So, yeah. There was a few droppings?
Yeah.
Well, we can check on them. And as I say, we're bringing our own super sleuth. So hopefully we'll be back to you in no time at all.
Well, you know, we haven't slept.
I can imagine. Yeah. It's a real worry. All right. Thanks, Bill.
Well, as you probably realise by now, this is really a serious crime. Now, we do believe that some of the top criminal minds of Great Britain are involved in this budgie napping. Bill himself doesn't believe that the budgie's been kidnapped, but we have our suspicions and our super sleuth.
Captain Biggie here at your service. And we're certainly going to look for this budgie and find it in no time at all. Right. Off we jolly well go. What? Fred. Ready, boy.
Fred. Is that you, Fred? Henry.
Captain Biggie here again, right. This is Diane Edge, she's an octhera, and she works at the...
Leighton OT department.
Leighton OT, right.
Yeah.
Diane, we're in a terrible tiff, right?
Oh dear.
We're looking for Fred the Budgie.
Ah.
He's green.
He's green, yes.
God bless his soul, he's lost his little tail.
Ah.
And he flew from... Bill Sheridan's... Was it his house? Yes, it was his house. And we followed the trail back here to the West Cheshire.
Yes.
Any ideas? Have you spotted him?
I haven't, no.
No, I'm afraid we haven't seen a budgie, no. No. A rather large canary, but no budgies.
Right. If you see him... Sorry, he's just going to change my birdseed. If you do spot him, could you get in touch with Bill on Airby Ward?
Right.
And your name is?
Miss Barlow, Caroline.
Pardon?
Do you realise how daft you're looking at?
Well, we're on the lookout for Fred the Budgerigar, who's disappeared from home.
Pink one. The pink one yesterday in the paper.
No, well, this one's pale green, actually.
No.
And he's lost his little tail.
Shame.
And he's run away from Bill Sheridan's home.
Believe it.
So...
Believe it, who wouldn't?
Where's Herbie Wood?
Right, yes, OK, Ollie. Yes, right. Spot on. Good lad.
Yes, well spotted. Yes, here they are now, yes. Over here, yes. Up in the tree. Now, back, 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 yes. Up a bit, yes. Got me? Okay. Right. Right, Captain Beaky here now, right. Now, I've been speaking to Ollie the Owl, and he's given us some new leads into the hunt for the missing budgie Fred. We're just going to fly off now to investigate those new leads, and we'll see you over at the aviary. See you a bit later. I'll just get up a bit of... Well, the mystery has finally unfolded itself here at the hospital aviary. Fred the budgie flew home. Yes, Fred is a homing budgie. So that's all that Captain Beacon can do now. I'll hand you back to Tony, who's speaking to Dave Edwards.
Right, Dave, that was certainly an unusual story about Fred the homing budgie. Have you ever had any experience like that before?
No, none at all. No, I haven't heard of any either. No.
Was there any? Can you think of any reason why the bird should fly all the way from Curzon Park back in?
And in such short time as well. Yeah. I've got a clue.
Well, his mother must have been cross with a homing pigeon.
That's what I thought. It's a coincidence as well, you know, because it's only that Bill was coming in to work that night. Otherwise, yeah. I would never have known.
Do you know where it was?
No.
It was over in the birdcage in the aviary.
In the birdcage?
A homing budgie gar.
Do you reckon he's given me a pigeon?
I don't know. I think he could have done and painted it green.
What were your comments on the wedding at the moment?
Nothing yet. I haven't seen much of it.
Haven't you seen the bridesmaids or the page boys?
Not yet.
What do you think of all the ceremony that they put on?
I think it's great.
You love it? You love every minute of it, yeah? You don't think it's a bit pompous or whatever?
No.
So you think keeping up with tradition is great?
Yes.
What's been done so far in Larkhamore? There's loads of decorations now. How long does that take you to do?
One of our patients, May Wotton, she made the bunting and all the, the cutout decorations. Our student nurse from the general section, she made a Union Jack cake. Joan has done all the, made the cakes, and we've all made sandwiches and we've bought different things. Lots of extras. To make it a special day.
Go on, you can say.
I'd like to actually say I'm very proud of all my staff because they've all worked extremely hard and the ward's beautiful.
They have made a really nice.
I'm really proud of them all.
It even goes so past to say it's better than mine and Sean's suits that we got from hospital.
Definitely.
And we're in big demand with these suits.
At last a bit of sun, although as I say the bunting is billowing in the wind, and the wind I think I have with me now Wally Amond, who's the organiser of the Beach Estate Party. The wind, I think, Wally, was a bit of a problem earlier in the day.
Yes, wind and rain. We had a lot of difficulties putting up the buntings, which we had to leave at the last minute, otherwise it would have been completely ruined. But it looks like we're getting a little bit of sunshine now. Let's hope it stays this way.
Now, it does seem as if you put on a tremendous spread here. I mean, we've got lots of tables out here. How much organisation has actually gone into putting this party on?
We started organising last May. That's the six families lives on the estate. Who are hospital workers, most of us nurses, and Alan Jones, who's a gardener.
Can I have a bit more background to this Miss Robin Hood 1986? Now, you were the one who landed Jill Vernon into it. Was it all as simple as she made out?
No, she had to put something into it.
Put something into it? Is this anything to do with the whittle or the wiggle or whatever?
The wiggle.
It was a wiggle. Yeah. Now, could you give us a quick idea of what the wiggle was about?
Well, they had to stand along the stage. Across the stage and all give a little wiggle. Well, I think she'd done the best one.
And that won her the title then? Do you think she was a deserving winner then? And what would you say, as an impartial observer, that she was the best?
She made everybody laugh.
Now, you're saying a very pleasant ward, the staff are lovely. Now, how do they compare, shall we say, to Whitby Ward? Because there have been a few cruel remarks, haven't there, from Whitby Ward?
A few jokers on Whitby, but certainly, especially that Janet Jones. But they're all lovely on there as well. I love working with them all. I miss them. I really do. The ward itself is totally different, as you've yourself seen. There's no way you can keep Whitby tidy, no matter what you do.
No, it's a standard measurement. I haven't ordered a standard wardrobe. I'm afraid you've got the wrong lady. That's right, yes. You've got the wrong person. Yes, it's a wardrobe, a white one. Yes, an empress.
Chris played
Empress.
3-3. And I played making it.
Can I have your name, please? Yeah, what's your name? Yeah. Oh, okay. It's a wind up.
It's a what?
A wind up about my wardrobe. Hello?
Oh, God.
Hello?
Who's talking?
New Year. Oh, that's super. Well, I'm not actually having a party, so. Yes, that's fine. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
What's it like to be on Viper Television, Janet?
Oh, no, I haven't been.
What year is it, Bob?
1972.
1972.
That's a very good look for the year.
It's an excellent motor car, Bob. And I think we did you a little disservice last week.
Well, I'm glad you realise that.
We're going to do now is to give you the opportunity to give us some word news from Airby. So you had a bit of news about Pat.
Yes, Pat, our racing assistant, Pat Dougal, that is. She's been away for a dirty weekend this week.
What was she doing?
Mud wrestling, Rossdale.
Mud wrestling in Rochdale.
I see her back on the feet anyway. And Billy's back now. Billy's back.
Yes, reported on his bad eyes last
Sheer
week.
Guy Sheridan. He's back now. He had ulcers on his eyes. No, sincerely, he had ulcers on his eyes, and he was quite bad, Billy. But he's back on duty now.
Well, it's nice to see Bill.
You missed
back.
Him. Yeah.
Right. Thanks very much, Bob. It's been very entertaining.
We're going to see Sheila's car now, are we?
Well, we've seen that.
Have you?
Yeah.
You didn't tell me about that, did you?
I'm sorry about that, Bob.
Not trying to say it's slow, but pedestrians pass it on the way to work. And she hasn't got rust as such. She's got woodworm.
I can't say any more of this.
Secondly, we'd like to wish Bridie Williams a lovely holiday in the Algarve.
Hello, Mark Newman on Sorgward. Firstly, a bit of news from the social club concerning the resident snooker ace, Keith Cyclone Carter. In preparation for his next round match, he has been busy practising all week, and last night, after 3 hours play in the snooker room, he did manage to hit a red.
The next item of world news, Mr O'Conn and Diane Jones, that's Mr O'Conn's a charge nurse, and Diane is a nursing assistant on Jarman Ward. They both entered for this year's marathon, which is going to be held on Sunday.
Hi, this is Steve Jones with the Baitshaw News. Everyone at Baitshaw would like to thank Sister Chris Strong and all the staff concerned for all the hard work put in preparation for this year's patient holiday.
Yeah, last week, Steve Mr Cool Jones read the ward news for Baitshaw, and what a splendid job he did, didn't he?
Wonderful, wonderful.
We didn't know he had a star amongst our mist. I mean, I think he even outshone Samara Hill, if that could be at all possible. And Steve has formed his own fan club, and if you send in £5 care of Viper TV, you'll receive a signed photo of Mr Cool himself. Me and Mark have tried to adopt some of his style today but it's probably a vain attempt and just a poor substitute, but we do our best.
Now, as you can see, sadly, well, we had to return from the holiday. We were forced to. But just to say that we really did enjoy the holiday immensely, although it was hard work because, as you know, we were self-catering.
As you're probably aware, 13 of us have just returned from a week's holiday in the Isle of Man, where we visited many interesting places, including Peel Castle, the Laxey Wheel and Castletown.
A ward raffle for the lads' holiday to collect funds for the holiday is still going on. You can buy tickets at tenpence each. First prize is a bottle of whiskey and the second prize is 3 litres of wine in a wine box. So if you'd like a ticket, they can be bought from ticket sellers who are going around in their own time.
Tomorrow, some of us are going to Warwick for a cricket match with the gym. Walter Maddox is coming, Doris Vaughan, Bill Taylor, and I'm going as well. So I hope we have good weather. Should be a lovely day.
The first one was on Thursday the 13th of June, when a small group, along with student nurse Judith Clegg and the staff from the gymnasium, travelled down to Warwick to watch a game of cricket between the side from Warwick and our own hospital side. This was enjoyed by all who attended, and fine weather and a packed lunch, plus the successful win of our cricket team, made the day even more enjoyable.
First of all, I'd like to say a very big thank you to United Reformed Church in Upton, as they've saved together £25 for ward funds.
Myself and Pat, the general student, are organising a coffee morning for July the 11th. We have a variety of things for sale, such as plants and nearly new items, and also we have a variety of refreshments as well.
I'd also like to say a big thank you to Crystalton High School. As you can see, they've come in today and donated all these presents for the ladies on the ward. I'm surrounded by all these goodies.
So it should be a good night to come along. And we've just had news just in. An Irish research chemist has apparently discovered a cure for which there is no known disease. That's it for this week. We'd like to sign off the way Steve Jones probably would.
Yeah.
And that's stay cool. Catch you next week.
Goodbye.
Ta-ra.
Anyway, gang, to all you would-be fans, Viper Television are a bit bogged down at the moment with all my fan mail. But if you can all wait patiently, you will be rewarded with a signed poster of Mr. Cool himself. Yes, you've guessed it, folks, yours truly. Anyway, fans, until next week, this has been Macho Man with the Baitchall News.
You know how the saying goes, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. And Rambo Calder gets going with Khaki Raban, a new fragrance from Paris, London, Rome, and Carton Ward. Yeah, Khaki, it's irresistible. Be careful though, even the famous Rambo isn't foolproof. But Rambo's no fool. He's a really khaki man. Khaki from Raban. Use it with care and beware. Khaki, probably the best fragrance in the world.
It used to be the International Voluntary Service, and there'd be an influx of about 30 or 40 volunteers from all over Europe, some perhaps not even able to speak English. And they'd come along and conduct some sort of a project.
August the 20th is a big day on the calendar in Frith Ward. It's the birthday of Ivy Clarkson, who this year is 92. And to mark the occasion, Frith staged a birthday extravaganza. Not quite an afternoon of wine, women and song, nonetheless a time when patients, relatives and staff can get together to celebrate. One of the highlights of the party is a visit by Ivy Clarkson's two sons. It's the one occasion in the year the three of them can meet up. But it's a reunion that involves a lot of planning and travel.
Well, OK, 1975 you started here.
As a student, yeah.
As a student, you've done your training. What sort of changes have you seen in 11 years?
Well, I've seen a lot. I've seen Edison Moston closing down for one. That's one big change. I mean, that was a sad day when that closed down, but it's progress, I suppose, people going in the community.
Did you spend much time at Moston?
Yeah, I spent much. Just on 12 months down there, on Hazel Ward, you know.
Yeah, that's right.
Huge admission, that's right. You were the charge, yes, of course, yeah.
Whether it was due to the bank manager's warning or the fact that nobody could make up their minds on the night, the only thing that went down well was the free tea and biscuits at the Littlewoods cafeteria. Thank you.
And patients on Barton Ward, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year 1987. And thank you to all the staff and patients for all the work in 1986. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Hi, Sister Mansfield from Acton Ward. I would just like to wish all the staff and all the patients throughout all the wards and all the departments a very happy Christmas. And a very happy and prosperous New Year.
Right, here we all are, staff and patients of Whitby Ward, having a very enjoyable Christmas party in the Phoenix Centre. And we'd like to take this opportunity to wish all the staff and patients in the hospital a very happy and enjoyable and relaxing Christmas.
Well, this is from Carly Ward, and this is Grant James, and all the staff and patients wishing you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hello everybody. As many of you will know, I'm Sue Dillon, the occupational therapist in the Heavy Workshop. And I was only thinking yesterday that this is the 22nd Christmas I've had at this hospital. And I'm sure a lot of you will have had a lot more. So I'd like to take this opportunity from all the staff in the Heavy Workshops to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year.
Just like to wish everybody a Happy Christmas and all the best for the New Year for the patients and staff at Hampton Ward.
A very Merry Christmas to all the patients in the hospital, from the staff and the patients of Malvern's Ward. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Well, I think from all the staff and patients, residents on Sorgel, we'd like to wish all our friends out there a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year for 87.
Everybody in the light.
patients of Delamere Ward would like to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
On behalf of all the ladies and the staff of Fifth Ward, we wish everyone in the hospital a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.